So students, for standard 7th biology, you will make two copies, one as homework copy and one as classwork copy. That homework copy should be small single line copy, and one classwork copy should be the big practical copy. Now the question answers of this chapter, tissues, after I discuss, you will write in the classwork copy. That is the big practical copy. Rest, all the homework or the assignments which you are getting, you will write in your homework copy. So tissues, the long question answers as well as the short question answers, you will write in your classwork copy. So let us begin the exercise of tissues. So page number 25, A, subpart A, name the following. The answers are written over here. You can have a look. First one, cell body of neuron is cytosine. Heart muscles, cardiac muscles. Parenchyma cells containing chloroplast, chlorenchyma. Next, move to fill in the blanks, subpart E. A long cylindrical process arising from the cytosine is called axon. Dash are forms of complex tissue, xylem and phloem. Parenchyma is present in the dash regions of the plant, softer. A nerve cell is called a neuron. Dash tissue is situated at the tip of root and stem and helps in growth of the plant, meristematic. Okay. Now let us move to the next, that is F, write true or false and correct the incorrect statement, that is subpart F. First one, xylem and phloem are the vascular bundles. Answer is false. The statement is false and you have to correct it. So, xylem and phloem are the vascular bundles, we will not write. Instead, you will write xylem and phloem are the vascular tissues. So, cut bundles and write tissues. Second, true or false is ligament connects bone to bone. So, the answer is, or the statement is true. Third, a nerve cell is called neuron. The statement is true. Next, the oxygen produced during photosynthesis comes from carbon dioxide. The statement is false. Instead of carbon dioxide, it should be water. So, you will correct the statement this way. The oxygen produced during photosynthesis comes from water. And the last statement is phloem and xylem together form the vascular bundles. You will write phloem and xylem. The answer is true because phloem and xylem together form the vascular bundles. So answer is true. Next, choose the correct answer. Okay, choose the correct answer. First one. This is subpart G. Let us start. A group of cells which is similar in structure and function is known as tissue. Voluntary muscles are option D, cylindrical and unbranched. Next option, next statement is the blood without the red corpuscle is subpart C, lymph. Xylem consists of subpart C, vessels, tracheids, fibers, and xylem parenchyma. Next is meristematic tissue have option D, continuously dividing cells. Next one is vascular bundles are composed of, answer is xylem and phloem, option B. Next is blood is, option B, connective tissue. Next, eighth one, movement or passage of food in the intestine is caused by the contractions of, option B, unstriated muscles. Ninth, ligament connects, option D, bone to bone. And 10th, parenchyma is a type of, option B, simple tissue. So G is over. Now move to H. Match the following. So match the following H. First one, xylem and phloem. Option number D is vascular bundles. So xylem and phloem you will match with vascular bundles, option D. Second, axon and dendrites you will match with neurons, that is option number E. Study of tissues is called histology, A. Growing tips of root are called meristems, option B. Heart, option C, cardiac muscle. Now move to the next, that is choose the odd one out, that is subpart D. Okay, so first you have to choose the odd one and then you have to give the reason. So let us start. Choose the odd one from each of the following. First question is epithelial tissue, meristematic tissue, muscular tissue, nervous tissue. So odd one is meristematic tissue. Why meristematic tissue is odd? Because it is plant tissue, whereas rest are animal tissues. So the answer is meristematic tissue. Reason is it is plant tissue, whereas rest are animal tissues. Second, blood, cartilage, lymph, plasma. Cartilage is odd. Why? Because it is skeletal tissue, whereas rest are vascular tissues. Okay, so cartilage is skeletal tissue, whereas rest are vascular tissues. Next one is parenchyma, collenchyma, xylem, sclerenchyma. So the odd one is xylem. Why? Because it is complex permanent tissue, whereas rest are simple permanent tissue. Okay, so the answer is xylem. Why? Because it is complex permanent tissue, whereas rest are simple permanent tissue. Next one is chiton, cardiac muscle, dendrites, axon. The odd one is cardiac muscle. Why? Because the rest are parts of neuron. Cardiac muscle is odd. Why? Because rest are parts of neurons. Okay. So now this one is all the objective ones are over. So let us start with the short answer questions. Okay. Let us start with the short answer questions. So the first question is which tissue is present in the growing tips of roots and stem? So the answer to it is apical meristematic tissue. Okay, The answer to first question, which tissue is present in growing tips of roots and stem? Answer is apical meristematic tissue. Second question, name the tissue that is responsible for the transmission of stimulus. So the answer is nervous tissue. Now the second part of this question is draw its diagram also. You will get the diagram clearly on page number 23. Next one is give the location and function of epithelial tissue. So location of epithelial tissue covers the external surface of the body. Okay. One more, location lines the cavities of internal organs. So this is the location, and coming to its function, provides protection and prevents the entry of germs. So function is provides protection and prevents the entry of germs. So this is the question number 3. Now move to question number 4. So students, we were discussing short answer questions of the chapter tissues, that is subpart B of the exercise. So fourth question is how are plant tissues classified? First part. Next is give an outline of this classification. So this answer is given on page number 9. Okay, now let us move to long answer questions. First question is, how is connective tissue different from other tissues? So let us start with this one, how is connective tissue different from other tissues? So the answer to this is, first you will write this answer point wise. That is, the cells of connective tissue are separated from each other. Next is, the space between the cells is composed of a non-cellular matrix. Okay. And the third point is connective tissue joins various parts of the body. That is why connective tissue is different from other tissues. So you will write the answer first as that, how is connective tissue different from other tissues? You will write, the cells of connective tissue are separated from each other. First point. Second point, the space between the cells is composed of a non-cellular matrix. And the third point is, connective tissue joins various parts of the body. That is why connective tissue is different from other tissues. Now the second question of subpart C, that is long answer questions, is name the various types of cells present in xylem. What is the function of this tissue? So the answer to this is, what are the elements present in xylem? First is vessels, tracheids, fibers, xylem, parenchyma. Now they have asked the function of xylem. So function of xylem is, xylem transports water and minerals from roots to different parts of the plant. So first they had asked for the elements present in xylem, or they had asked for the various types of cells present in xylem. So these are the cells present in xylem. And the next they have asked for the function. So function is, xylem transports water and minerals from roots to different parts of the plant. Now question number 3. Give a brief account of various types of cells found in connective tissue. So this answer you will get on page number 18, that flow chart which is given. you will write that, as well as the next is give a brief account of various types of cells found in connective tissue. First, you will draw the flow chart, which is given on page number 18 for connective tissue. Next, you will refer to the previous video from the chapter pages 18, 19 and 20, you will get the this answer, that is a brief account of various types of cells found in connective tissue. Next question is give outline classification of animal tissues. So that you will get on page number 16, the flow chart which is given for animal tissues, that is the answer to this question. Okay, page number 16, flow chart of animal tissues. And the last question is define muscular tissue. Classify and explain different types of muscles with the help of diagram. So the answer to that is, first part of it is, what is or define muscular tissue. So you will define muscular tissue as, muscular tissue is a contractile tissue which has long cylindrical cells called muscle cells or muscle fibers and helps in movement of our body. So what is define muscular tissue? Muscular tissue is a contractile tissue which has long cylindrical cells called muscle cells or muscle fibers and helps in movement of our body. So this is the answer to the first part, define muscular tissue. Second part is classify and explain different types of muscles with the help of diagram. So you will get the classification and explanation on page number 22, the table which is given over there. So that is the way you will explain that, and the diagram of this muscular tissue, that is three types of muscles, you will get on page number 22. So this way we complete the exercise of tissues. Listen students, the last part of the exercise of the chapter tissues which is left is subpart I. So let's discuss the answers of subpart I, that is differentiate between the following. Now one thing students, you will write the differences the same way as I had explained in the previous videos. That is, the main point should be written. Now let us discuss this. Differentiate between the following. First one is voluntary, involuntary and cardiac muscles. The answer is given on page number 22. The answer is given on page number 22. Point wise, you will write the answer. Next is parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. The answer is given on page number 12. In form of table, the answer is given. You will write the same way, but only the points which I had discussed in the previous videos. Next is xylem and phloem. It's given on page number 14. The differences between xylem and phloem is given in form of table on page number 14. Next is meristematic and permanent tissue. The answer is given on page number 15. So you will write the answers of these in the copy. That is short answer, long answers and differentiate between the following should be in your classwork copies. Okay, so next day, new chapter, students.